Quite a celebratory mood here at the Cranley camp. The 69th mayor of Cincinnati will be John Cranley. He is the mayor-elect. He rode the streetcar issue to victory and strong support in the African-American community. He just said, I'm proud and honored to be your next mayor. Let's listen in to John Cranley and the new First Lady of Cincinnati, Dina Cranley.
Thank you. Dina and I and my parents and my brother Mike are all here, and my wife's family is here, and we want to say thank you to the voters and the people of this city. We believe we're going to bring this city together, and we're going to work on uniting the city to move it forward in a way that works for all people. We're going to work in a bipartisan fashion. We're going to reach across the aisle. We're going to focus on the priorities that we think will get this city back together. What is that vision? We want this city to be the best city in America. Yeah. Yeah. To be where every family and every business wants to locate, every family wants to raise its family. And we know we can get there. No city has the advantages that we have if we just use them. And here's what we're going to do. We are going to focus, of course, a job creation. We're going to work with the chambers. We're going to work with the community to build jobs and bring businesses to Cincinnati. And we're going to work to reduce the poverty rate over the next 5 years. Second, there are far too many shootings and violence in this city, and we're going to put more cops and firefighters on the street. And we are going to reduce more shootings. Third, we are going to get the city's fiscal house in order. Yeah. And we're going to do that by balancing the budget in a real way. So we are not going to sell off resources. We're going to keep our resources, invest in the people of Cincinnati. We're going to get out of a project like the streetcar, which is too expensive. Too expensive. I also want to say that we are going to find solutions to bring this city together. Yes. There are ways. The streetcar supporters have all the best intentions and their hearts in the right place. It's just the solution they've got is too expensive. We're going to find an alternative. We're going to find an alternative that will build upon the vibrancy of downtown and create a 24/7 nightlife. Yeah. Yeah. We're going to build a more inclusive city. Yeah. As Alicia Rose and Christopher Smitherman know, and Dwight Tillery and so many others, we can't succeed with the kind of disparity we have between the black and the white community and the Hispanic community. So we're going to build a community that works for everyone. And lastly, we're going to work to revitalize all of our neighborhoods, because as I know, in Price Hill and so many other neighborhoods, these neighborhoods can be revitalized. So let me finish by saying two things. First, that I honor deeply the service that my opponent, Vice Mayor Roxanne Qualls, has given to this city. And let's applaud again her service to this community. She has given most of her life to public service. And lastly, let me say once again, thank you. I am humbled, I am honored, and I'm going to work to bring this city together and move it forward, because this city has given so much to my wife and me and to our families, and we feel a debt and an obligation to give back. Thank you all so very much.
Well, there you have it. Huge cheers going up for the 69th mayor of the city of Cincinnati, John Cranley, who did it tonight by strong support on the west side and strong support in African-American neighborhoods. And you heard him here lay out his agenda, the agenda that he talked about all during the campaign. We're live at Jefferson Social. John London, WLWT News Phone.